Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video, guys. If you have a BMW, guys, 7 Series, any generation 7 Series, let's say E38, E65, E66, F01, guys, and you're trying to test your coolant temperature sensor, stay with us and we'll explain, guys, how to do that. The procedure is super simple and you can do it at home. You will need a voltmeter and water at different temperatures. We'll explain as we go, guys. Now, why we're doing that, because sometimes if you have problems with the coolant temperature sensors, why to buy a new one, guys, and waste your money when you can test yours and see if that's the problem. It could be sometimes even a broken wire. It could be in some cases even an engine computer that's not communicating correctly with the sensor because it has a problem somewhere, guys. So we'll explain, guys, how to test your sensor. All the tools, parts, everything that we use in our videos, including if you need to buy a new sensor for your 7 Series, check out the link in the description of the video below and you can see where we get our parts and tools from, guys. We do that for your convenience. Now, another thing, guys. Every single car we get at the shop, we make at least 200 free repair videos. Why we do that? Simply because our mission at the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, please subscribe to the channel and like the video. So, let us show you now, okay, what we have here, guys. This is the temperature sensor. We have a couple graphs here. We have the voltmeter going. We have one pot with water. Okay, and we have the thermometer. And just before we start, okay, let me tell you something, guys. If you have a car, BMW especially, check out this channel, Auto Repair, guys. We have, guys, helped more than 71 million people on this channel. We have so helpful information that can save you thousands of dollars on future repairs. So check it out and subscribe, guys. Definitely, you will find the information helpful. Now, we have, guys, a pot of water here. And that water, okay, we're going to check the temperature in a second, but right here, this is the sensor. On the sensor, okay, we have two wires and we're going to install alligator clips, okay, so we can connect it to the voltmeter. We have the voltmeter set at ohm readings. Now we have two graphs, guys. One is in Fahrenheit, one is in Celsius. We use the Celsius one, but we'll share the Fahrenheit as well if you're living in a country that uses Fahrenheit and you're used to it. So, that being said, guys, this is your temperature, water temperature. This is the ohm reading for the left graph here. And the right graph uses that ohm reading, so it's more detailed. Now, let's say our water, we'll start with cooler water at about, okay, what's our, let me see, now, 27. So, at 25 degrees, we should be about 700 reading to about 23. And we're at 1900 ohms, guys. So that's great. Now we'll start heating the water up and we'll check the temperature at certain temperature to see if our reading output actually corresponds to the output, okay, in the graphs. Make sure that our sensor is pulling out the same ohms as the one in the graph. So we have the heating torch going now. You can just even heat up the water on a cooking stove, guys. Pretty simple too, but we're here at the garage, so that makes it a little bit more convenient. And we're going to check the water at different temperatures now. So let's test it at 35 degrees. It's almost there, you can see. You have to stir the water so you don't get a cold spot. Okay, perfect. Right there, 1500 ohms reading on the multimeter. So 1500, according to our thing, we should be about 1200 to 1700. So we're right on the spot, guys. Perfect. Now we're going to compare it at 50 degrees. At 50, we should get about 750 to about 1000 ohms. So let's compare now. You can see how fast the water is heating up with that little torch. Okay. So between 750 and about 1000. Okay, the water is getting there. Oh, right there. 870, guys. We are doing great so far. You can see it 50 degrees. Now, we keep doing that and next I'll compare it. Okay, let's say at about, guys, okay, 70 degrees and we should have a 370 reading, 370 to about 470 maybe, guys, at 70 degrees. So, you can see we keep going. Now we are about 55, 650. So, everything's so far, guys, great through the graph. Everything matches, and you can see how our ohms keep dropping the more you actually heat up the water, guys. So everything's doing great so far. Now I'm going to compare again and see what we get here. 61, we're getting close. 63, sometimes when it jumps, that's because the sensor goes by. 65, 66, 67, we're almost getting there. Okay, 69, so we have about 390 reading, guys, at 70 degrees, and we're right on the spot. So you can see that's how you can do it, guys. This is one good sensor. We can turn the heat off, you can compare it through the whole graph and see if it, at every temperature, it falls in that graph, and it should be good, guys. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching, and see you guys next time.